Guys, and welcome back to the channel. In the last video, I have shown you how to make a very simple and powerful mini book converter, which is was based on LM2576, but it was having a drawback. It didn't feature any CC or custom current capability. So in this video, I will show you how can you make another bus converter which will be more powerful than the first one. The book converter will be based on XL4016, which according to the datasheet, it is a 180 kHz fixed frequency PWM book or step down DC to DC converter, capable of driving a 8 ampere load with a high efficiency, low ripple, an excellent line and load regulation. The circuit is very simple and easy to replicate if needed, so give it a try. Now let's have a look at the schematic, which is now in front of you. The main IC, it is from the family XL, so it is the XL4016, which is a very common IC which can be found on any book module which they are on the internet. Switch converters such as book converter provide much greater power efficiency as DC to DC converter, that linear regulator, which they are simple circuit that lower voltage by dissipating power as heat, but doesn't step up output current. Like with the LM2576, the principle of the circuit operation is the same. This is a simple voltage regulated with short circuit protection, so called book converter. The basic operation of a book converter has the current in an inductor controlled by two switches, usually a transistor and a diode. Ideally, in a converter, all the components are near considered to be perfect. Significantly, the switch and the diodes have a zero voltage drop when they are on and zero current when the switch is off. And the inductor has zero series resistance. Further, it's assuming that the input and output voltage doesn't change over the course of a cycle. This will imply the output capacity as being infinite. But something like this is more or less a theory, because usually every component has a higher or lower ESR or equivalent series resistor or inductor, sort of like ESL. The simplified topology behind this operation is the same as flyback converter, by using an inductor choke with a minimum of two winding and a galvanic isolation between them. The pin 3 is so called the switch on the XL4016. To this pin, we have to connect our inductor, which in my case it's around 60mH toroidal inductor, along with an external diode which has to be a fast switching one and as well to have a lower 4 voltage drop. So I choose the CBR20100CT, which can stand up to 100 volts and 20 amperes. Let's not forget the XL4016 has an internal 8 ampere transistor. For this reason, we don't need an external switch, the switching is done internally. After the two mandatory resistors create a voltage divider, the lower R10, it is 3.3K. This value is needed for stabilizing the voltage reference. By turning the variable resistor R9, we can adjust the output voltage from the voltage which was set by the resistor R10 to our supply voltage. For the inductor, I was using a ferrite powder core, which I winding it up using 1.25 mm emailed wire. I wind around 25 thirds, which is equal around 0.60 mH, I say it will be enough. The main and the output capacitor I have choose, they are 35 volts at 220 microfarads. The more filtering we will be using at the output, the more reserve power we will have. The CC or current control, it will be based on MCP602, which is a dual op-amp configured as a differential amplifier with a gain of around 30. The power of the MCP602, it will be provided by a simple 5 volts linear regulator based on AMS1117. For the shunt, I choose this one, which is around 0.1 ohm. You can use any, at least with 2 watts capability of power. The two 1N4148 diodes, they are used in junction with the voltage divider from the R9 and R10. Here you can omit one and go with only one if you will be powering the MCP602 from a 3.3 volts linear regulator. The R1 and R2 from the MCP602 are forming a simple voltage divider. By turning the R2, we can offset the output of the second comparator, and so we can adjust the current with it. Now let's start with the building process by grabbing all the required components and soldering them like all the time on a prototyping board, which is often called Vero board. Starting first by adding a heatsink to our XL4016 and as well to the SBR20100CT to keep it cool. After, we can proceed further by adding the components and soldering them according to the schematic. For making the connection on the board, mostly I was using solder and some resistor wire for strengthen the tracks on the main PCB. After, let's add the last components and we are ready for the first test. Now let's set the bench power supply to around 15 volts and let's connect the book converter to the supply. And as you can see, by turning the R9, we can adjust the voltage pretty easily. Let's test it. For testing, I will be using a variable rheostat, which is capable of sustaining up to 150 watts, so it will be plenty. And let's add another multimeter for seeing the current. Let's turn the R2 potentiometer and as you can see, we can adjust the current pretty much very easily. And as well, by connecting a probe to the pin 3 of our switch, we can see how the duty cycle is getting lower or higher depending on the load. And as well, we can observe the frequency at higher load is going up. This is because at higher load the switch it will be more open, and when the load is smaller it will be off, so it will oscillate. So after all, this was a fun project to make, and as well on the board I have enough space for a second one. This will be great for a simple symmetrical power supply, but this is a subject for another video. So this was all for today. I hope I will see you all in my next video. Until then, have a nice day and thank you very much for watching. See ya!